Welcome to the how-to studio. In this video, I will show you how to scan from your Canon inkjet printer. This solution will work for almost all Canon inkjet printers. I'm also going to show you how to scan multiple files into one PDF on your Canon printer. Now, the software that we're going to use to scan is called Canon Print, and I'm going to show you two ways how you can get this Canon Print software. So the first way to get it is you're going to click on the Start menu, and then you're going to go to the Microsoft Store. Once the Microsoft Store app opens up, you're going to search for Canon Print. Canon Print. And then you're going to either click the Enter button, or since it pops up here, you can go ahead and click on Canon Print. And then you're going to install it. Right now it's showing open for me because I've already installed it, but for you, you should see the option to install it. The next way for you to install this Canon Print app is to actually do so in Google. So in Google, you're just going to type in Canon Print and you're going to search for it. Now you're going to scroll down for the option that says Microsoft Apps, and you're going to click on Canon Print, and then you can go ahead and download the Canon Print app. Now let's go back to the Canon Print app. Okay, so on the Canon Print app, when you first open this app, you'll see a pop-up with some terms and conditions. You can go ahead and select the option that applies and click OK. And then if you see any other pop-up, just go ahead and click OK. And I've already connected my printer, so it's already showing my Canon printer. But you'll need to add your Canon printer to this. Just follow the steps to set it up. Before you hit scan, you want to go ahead and make sure that you put your paper into your printer for it to scan. And you also want to make sure that your printer is correctly connected and it says online. Once that's done, then you go ahead and click on scan. And then here, you're going to state whether you have a document or a photo. Mine is a document. It is actually a letter size document, so you can choose the size of your document, and you can also choose the resolution, but I am going to leave it here as is. As you can see here, it says that if you increase the resolution, it will result in a higher quality image, but it will also increase the time required to scan. So next, what you want to do is you want to make sure that your paper or your picture is in your scanner, and then you're going to click on scan. And as you can see, it says that it's scanning. Okay, so it's just going to take a few seconds to finish scanning. Okay, it has finished scanning. Now we can see the paper that I have scanned here, and it shows you the number of pages. That is one page, and we do have some options over here that we can play around with. Now this function, you can rotate the paper if you want to, as you can see. So for example, if you put a picture there and it was upside down, you can turn it around using this feature. You can also crop, and this has a rotate feature as well. So if you want to crop your paper or your image, you can do that as well. You can slant it, and this is where you can rotate left and right. Let me click cancel. You can play around with this image correction function. You can choose your format, PDF or PNG or JPEG. And you can, this part is important, if you're going to scan multiple pages, you click to save all pages. So you can choose if you only want to save the current page or you want to save all pages. And this option is super important, save multiple pages into a single file. And that's exactly what this video is about. So you want to make sure this is checked. And to add multiple pages, you want to click this button to click add. But first of all, ensure that you have your other paper that you want to scan in your scanner. So I've added my other paper to my scanner. Then I'm just going to click this plus button, and then I'm going to choose the options as before, and then I'm going to click on scan. and it's scanning, and it's going to take a few seconds. Okay, here we go. So we can see that paper number 2 has been scanned, and you see that it labels it 1 and 2, and I can navigate between the two pages. So you can keep on clicking this button to add more and more pages and scan multiple pages. And it will be important for these two options. If you want to scan all your pages into one single PDF file, it's important to select the Save All Pages option. And also select this option that says Save Multiple Pages to a Single File. There is also an option to delete. So if you want to delete a page, for example, if I wanted to delete page 2, you can just click the Delete option here. And then you confirm by clicking Yes. And now you see I only have one page, and you can also use this option that says revert to original if you made changes and you want to revert it back to what it was before. Once you have done adding all your pages and scanning all your pages, then you want to click on save. And now you can choose where you want to save your file, and you can name your file. So you can name it anything you want, and then I'm gonna go ahead and save it. And as you can see, it says it's saving, and it gives you the link here to where your file is saved, and you can just go ahead and click it, or you can just go into the folder where you saved it and open that file. So I'm gonna click it to open this file so we can take a look at what I have scanned. So here we go. As you can see, I had scanned 2 pages, and as you can see, my 2 pages are here in one single PDF file. With this app, you can scan multiple pages into a single PDF file, and it works for almost any Canon printer, so I would definitely suggest that you give it a try. It's very easy to use and very convenient, and as you saw, there's multiple features on it that makes it customizable for you to make your scans perfectly the way how you want them to work. I hope this video was helpful for you. Please leave a thumbs up and also subscribe. If you have any questions, please leave a comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.